Preface saying the Audu Billahi Minash Shaitana Rajim and Basmala Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, I begin writing my book. Alhamdu Lila. If any person thanks another person in any manner for any reason at any place or time, all this HAMD and thanks will in fact have been said to Allahu Ta'ala. For Allahu Ta'ala alone creates and develops everything and renders every favor done. He alone is the owner of might and power. Unless he reminds, no one can wish or ever think of doing good or evil. Whatever happens is only what he wills. May the best of prayers and favors be upon Muhammad Mustafa, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who is his prophet and most beloved slave, the most beautiful, the most superior of mankind in every respect. Also, may Allah be pleased with the prophet's family and companions and all those who love and follow them. Every man, and even every living being, wants to live in comfort, without sorrow and without trouble or pain. Savants, scientists, and governments have all been trying to establish these conditions for the world's people. To attain this, various ideas and methods have been developed, and everyone is defending the way he thinks is better and more useful. As unanimously declared by hundreds of thousands of Islamic savants who have lived throughout the last 14 centuries and as well by all the correct religions which guided people to the way of comfort and peace in all parts of the world before Islam, there's one single way that will lead people to happiness and comfort. This unique way is through Iman, which means to believe in the existence of one single creator who created everything. As unanimously declared by hundreds of thousands of Islamic savants who have lived throughout the last 14 centuries and as well by all the correct religions which guided people to the way of comfort and peace in all parts of the world before Islam, there's one single way that will lead people to happiness and comfort. This unique way is through Iman, which means to believe in the existence of one single creator who created everything from nothing, who alone always makes everything, and who is almighty, such that what he wishes happens. The name of this single owner of power is Allah. Every goodness, every superiority belongs to him only. There is no weakness or deficiency in him. He has always existed. He never ceases to exist. He alone keeps everything in existence every moment. If he ceased to exist for one moment, everything would immediately cease to exist too. To have belief in him, it is necessary to believe and accept all his declarations, commandments, and prohibitions. Hence, there are a number of things to believe in. Islamic savants have summarized them into six groups. They are called principles of Iman. To believe in these six principles means to believe in everything that is necessary. The following are the six principles of Iman. 1. To learn all his 5 sifat idadiyah and his 8 sifat ithubutiyah and to believe in them. 2. To learn and believe in the teachings that are necessary to believe in about angels. 3. To learn the names of the 4 heavenly books sent by Allahu Ta'ala and to believe that they are all his word. Allahu Ta'ala sent each book to a prophet by way of an angel. He sent the Quran to Hadrat Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is permissible to translate or interpret the Quran in any language and to learn the meaning of the Quran as well as possible by reading such translations and interpretations. But reading the translations is not the same as reading the Quran. For, not only the meanings of the words of the Quran are called the Quran, but also the words together with their meanings represent the Quran. 4. To believe in prophets. The first of the prophets was Hadrat Adam, alayhi salam. The last and the highest prophet was Hadrat Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The number of prophets who came between the two is not known. 5. To believe in the last day. That day is doomsday. That is when every living thing will be annihilated. Afterwards they will all be resurrected, men will rise from their graves and after being called to account, some of them will go to paradise and others to hell. 6. To believe in Qadar. Allahu Ta'ala knows in advance the things he will create. This knowledge of Allahu Ta'ala is called Qadar. Everything according to Qadar is created when the time comes. Men cannot change Allah's Qadar. Today, the earth has only one book sent down by Allah that has not undergone human interpolation. This undefiled and perfect book is the Quran Al-Karim. He who believes in the six principles of Iman is declared by the Quran Al-Karim becomes a mu'min or Muslim. Only Hadrat Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, understood the meaning of the Quran correctly, and he explained it to those Muslims who were with him. Each of these explanations of Hadrat Muhammad is called Hadith-i-Sharif. Those Muslims who saw Hadrat Muhammad's beautiful face are called the Sahaba. Islamic savants who came later learned the meanings of the Quran from the Sahaba, and they wrote them in their books. They are called the savants of Allah's Sunnah. Hadrat Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, informed us that they were the true Islamic savants. Working day and night, the higher ones of those savants learned the various methods of worshipping within the context of what had newly happened and of what would arise later. They always adapted their methods of worshipping in accordance with what they had learned from the Sahaba, and they in turn taught them to their disciples. The highest ones among the Allah's Sunnah are called Mu'tahid Imams. And some other savants who preferred their own minds and opinions gave new meanings disagreeing with the knowledge concerning the Quran conveyed to them by the savants of the Allah's Sunnah. Thus they deviated from the teachings of Iman communicated by the savants of the Allah's Sunnah. If this deviation of theirs does not involve the clear declarations of the Quran, those who hold that belief are still Mu'mins, Muslims. But they are bidat holders, heretics. If their deviation involves matters declared clearly, such misbelievers lose their iman and become disbelievers. They, and also those who believe as they do, are called mulhids. Their thinking of themselves as Muslims and declaring that they are on the right way will not rescue them from being disbelievers. It is written in all the books of fiqh, and especially in Ibn Abidin, under the chapters dealing with iman, it has been unanimously said, by savants, that if a person disbelieves in one of the facts that are necessary for one to know to be a Muslim, he becomes a kafir, disbeliever, even if he is ala qibla, that is, performs the prayers in congregation, one, and does all kinds of worship throughout his life. If a belief disagreeing with the savants of the Allah's Sunnah is not a result of interpreting the Quran erroneously, but by following one's own short mind, understanding, opinion or the day's scientific knowledge, one who believes so becomes a kafir. Such disbelievers are called religion reformers. For example, a person who disbelieves in the torment in the grave and in the Shafi'a intercession that will take place in the next world is either a heretical Muslim who is Allah bidat, or a disbeliever who is a religion reformer. A religion reformer thinks of himself as a Muslim, too. An enemy of Islam who is not a Muslim but who gives wrong meanings to the Quran by pretending to be a Muslim in order to defile and demolish Islam from within is called a zindiq. It is difficult for youngsters to distinguish between these three types of disbelievers. Each of Allah's commandments is called a fard. His prohibitions are called haram. The Mu'tahid Imams, who were the highest of the savants of the Allah's Sunnah, in their search for documents in order to decide about certain matters, disagreed with one another in some matters. Thus, various madhhabs emerged. Among them, the books of the famous four madhhabs spread everywhere, and the other madhhabs were forgotten. He who wants to attain happiness in this world, in his grave, and in the next world must, after adapting his iman to the Allah's Sunnah, live in obedience to one of the four madhhabs. In other words, all his worships and actions must be suited to one madhhab. Of the four madhhabs, he must choose the one that is the easiest for him to learn and follow. After learning it, he must act in accordance with it in everything he does. Savants of the Allah's Sunnah declared unanimously that when doing a certain matter, it is not permissible to mix the four madhhabs with one another. That is, it is never permissible to do one part of a matter or worship according to one madhhab and another part according to another madhhab. If one does so, one will have disobeyed the unanimity of the savants and will have followed none of the madhhabs. To follow one madhhab means to learn it and to intend to follow it. It is not acceptable to follow it without intending to do so. Hadrat Abdul Ghani Nablusi wrote in his book Khulasatu Taqiq fi Bayani Hukumat Taqlid wa Tafiq, admitting someone else's word or proof without understanding it is called taqlid, imitation, following. A Muslim who is not a Mu'tahid has to do his every act of worship and everything by imitating a Mu'tahid. It is permissible for him to imitate one Mu'tahid when doing one thing and to follow another Mu'tahid when doing another thing for the first time. But after having done one thing according to one mod hab, he has to do that thing by imitating continuously the same mod hab, except when there is a darurat, strong necessity, too, not to do so. During the times of the Sahaba and the Tabi'in, the newly converted Muslims would do so. Likewise, he who imitates only one madhab in everything he does cannot imitate another madhab unless there is a strong necessity. As it is seen, when there is a strong necessity, it is permissible to do worships and everything else according to another madhab. But in this case, it will be necessary to learn that madhab well and to observe its conditions. A person who does not follow a madhab is called alam arobi. Alam arobi person cannot be Allah's son at 3, his worships are not sahih, correct, valid. It is haram to change one's madhab for worldly advantages in order to obtain the desires of one's nafs. 4. Each Muslim must learn at least one madhab and to adapt his daily life to it. To annihilate Islam, the enemies of Islam attack the Allah's son at by state and financial forces. In all parts of the world they prevented the educating of Islamic savants. They annihilated the schools of the Allah's Sunnah and the books of the Allah's Sunnah. This aggression was led by the British. Today, as it can be seen, there are no books of the Allah's Sunnah, nor any savants of the Allah's Sunnah left in many countries. Brought up ignorant, the youth are easily being deceived, misled, and swept into perdition by mulhids, lamadhabis, and religion reformers. I have deemed it necessary to spread all over the world in English the teachings of fiqh by way of my Turkish book Sayyidai Bedi. I prepared this book as a service to innocent youngsters. Thus the fourth fascicle of my book Endless Bliss has been formed. I have prepared this book by translating fiqh books of the Hanafi madhab. If those youngsters who are in another madhab or who have not been able to learn the teachings of din, religion, read this book and do all their matters and worships accordingly, they will have imitated the great Islamic savant Hadrat Imam I'Azam Abu Hanifa Numan bin Thabit, the leader of the savants of the Allah's Sunnah, the great Imam and Mutlaq Mu'tahid. Thus, their worships will be sahih, they will escape the calamity of having deviated from the Allah's Sunnah. May Allah Ta'ala protect us all from being deceived by the insidious enemies of Islam, from being trapped by Lamadobi people and by religion reformers who bear Muslim names. Ameen. Hussein Hilmi bin Said Ishik Isik Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alai 1329-1911 AD Fazir Tekezi El Yub Sultan Istanbul 1422-2001 Istanbul.